last we studied was in event marketing. Now we'll continue further with emerging ethical issues in marketing. First of all, before going to the topic, let us understand what is ethics. What do you understand by ethics? Ye word ko jana pehchana lag raha hai. What is exactly ethics? It is nothing but the moral values that are given to us right from our birth age. The basic sense of understanding what is right and what is wrong. Okay. Now, for example, a small example. Kisi ko marna obviously galat hai. But 10 logon ko bachane ke liye kisi ko marna, ye kisi ko sahi bhi lag sakta hai aur galat bhi lag sakta hai. But ultimately killing somebody or hitting somebody is wrong. So it depends or it varies from person to person that how he or she is, you know, taking the ethical values as, or how the morals or principle he has laid for himself. Now going further, we'll talk about ethical issues in marketing, particularly first misleading advertising. Jab bhi hum TV on karte, obviously advertising is the first part of television. Without advertising, none of the serials are, you know, you won't like to watch, or basically it is a medium which has been used to market the product. We all are aware of that. Yes. Now advertising, basically hum kafi sari ads aise hote hain jo hum dekhte hi samajh jate hain ki kya ullu bana raha hai, kya bakwas bol raha hai. Okay, like ek example main batati hu, jaise Garnier Fructis, you all are aware of this product. Okay, so Garnier Fructis ka ek advertisement mujhe yaad aa raha hai. Now where one girl, okay, right in shorts, a foreigner girl, okay, she is coming out of her place and she is tying her hair to the truck which has been stuck in some pond, and she is dragging the truck out of the pond. Now practically, is that feasible? Now what they were trying to show is you use Garnier Fructis, Garnier Fructis se baal long and strong hote hain. Agreed, chalo theek hai, advertisement dekhe to yahi lag raha hai. But now you try to analyze the ad, what you actually find? सबसे पहले हम अपने बालों से नॉट बांधने की ट्राई करें, नॉट नहीं बनता. सेकेंड, एक फॉरेनर लड़की हमारे यहाँ पे इंडिया में आके ट्रक खींचने के लिए क्यों आएगी? एंड थर्ड, वहाँ पे इतने सारे लोग खड़े थे, नोबडी इज हेल्पिंग हर आउट, एंड ओनली द गर्ल विद सो थिन गर्ल शी इज एबल टू लिफ्ट द ट्रक कम्प्लीटली. सो दीज काइंड ऑफ एड व्हेन वी सी, व्हाट वी एक्चुअली अंडरस्टैंड, क्या पागल बना रहे. एक ही सेंटेंस में हम बोलते हैं क्या पागल बना रहे. और एक एडवर्टाइजमेंट लाइक एक्स डीओ का. A guy is applying a XDO and almost 100 to 1000 girls are following her, crazy about her. Okay, DO लगाने से अगर ऐसा ही होता तो सबसे पहले भिखारी DO लगाता, so that he can attract attention of the people and he can earn a big amount. Do we agree to this? Yes. So ethical issue, सबसे पहला misleading advertisement. The advertisement which are showcased by these companies are completely misleading. Paragons चप्पल से किसी की life बचा सकते हो? What shit is that? We don't agree to this. Yes, but still, because somebody else is promoting it, like for example, Paragon ad has been shown by or is advertised by Salman Khan. Yes, so many people, many fan following, lot of fan following of Salman Khan, people are just blindly buying that product. What is that? Again, misleading advertisement, but again, it is generating revenue. Okay, so ultimately, what business want is profit, revenue, which they are getting through showcasing unethical advertisements. Next is varying global norms pertaining to ethics. Now everybody, just now as I said that one case and two people can view it differently. Like for example, what I feel is right might be somebody else might not feel it is right. Like I feel killing one person is wrong or killing animal is wrong, but somebody who is a non-vegetarian, for him killing is like so simple. Okay, so it differs from person to person. Now imagine we are in a global world. Global world means what? We have opened up our economy for foreign companies to come and have their business in India and our business going in foreign countries. Now obviously when two different countries are indulging marketing or advertisement format, now every country people, okay, have different views, every country has different norms. So that's what over here I'm trying to say, varying global norms pertaining to ethics. Every country, every global market has different set of rules, regulation or ethics. Okay, so understood by the second point. Now third, let us go to the third point, that is unhealthy competition. Now what do you mean by unhealthy competition? Because of, before going to the topic, let us understand how competition have rose. Because of LPG, that is liberalization, privatization and globalization, what has happened? Our economy has opened up. Now once economy has opened up, the competition have become intense. How come? Because all companies are coming in India, even Indian companies are going somewhere in abroad. Okay, now initially there were few sellers, or I'll say handful of sellers and many buyers. Now what is the case has become? Now there are n number of sellers, and not only n number of sellers, but for single product there are n number of brands which are there. we get, as a customer, we get to choose n number of products, and from even not only n number of products, but for one product also we have so many buyers. Now these buyers are competing amongst themselves to grab the attention of the customer, to attract the customer, to retain the customer. Now in order to retain and attract customers, they are adopting all unethical ways and means. The very good example is a war between Pepsodent and Colgate. The open war which was taken place few months back by Pepsodent against Colgate. The open war again between Pepsi and Thumbs Up. These are nothing but they are completely using unethical ways to promote their product. That means the third point itself means unhealthy competition. Competition is there but trying to grab the attention of the customer by all unhealthy ways and means. Third, online marketing. Now, what is online marketing? I don't think we are new to this word. Online marketing, we all know what is online marketing. Buying and selling activities carried out online. Okay. Now, what kind of unethical practices are carried out online? That there are number of cases which have been increased, like quality is deteriorated. Whatever is shown online is not what is delivered. Again, after sales services which are expected are not received at times. Okay, first copy products have been sold out in this online business. So basically they are also, by cutting short the expenses, okay, by getting this manufacturer and the customer closer, the products are obviously offered at a discount rate, but at what pace, at what cost? That is quality compromise, or it is like, you know, removal of middlemen, and again the trust, security, or when it comes to payment is all absent. So that's why online marketing again is one of the major ethical issues with today's marketing managers are facing. Next is growing environmental concern. We all know that environment is degrading day by day. We know that company, in order to survive, they use, or you know, to manufacture, they use water, soil, everything. Okay, everything that is required which is available in the environment. Now these companies, for their own survival purpose, they misuse these minerals, these available natural resources. Now because of which the pollution has been reached to the topmost level. Like for example, if you say emission of carbon dioxide through vehicle or petrol and diesel vehicles, which have been a growing concern in today's time. So again, but how to stop the selling of these cars? Nobody can stop. Why? Because again, companies are coming up with good discounts and bumper offers and everything. So again, that has contributed to our unethical practices in marketing. Like marketing the product at a cheap price or a low price and attracting the customer, thereby even polluting or damaging the environment. Let's go next point, that is pricing of essential commodities. Recently we saw a high price in vegetables. Now how, right, for example, last few months back I just saw onions are being sold at 80 rupees a kg, whereas at that time I saw a interview which was taken by a DNA person of a farmer. He took basically an interview of a farmer, where farmer told that he is selling the onions 4 rupees per kg. He is selling to whom? The wholesaler. Now what these wholesalers do? Wholesaler hoard this essential item. Hoarding means they are not allowing it to get supplied in the market. Now we all know that vegetables are a necessity item. When there is a more of demand of a product and supply is less, what happens to the price? Try to recollect your economics. When the demand is more, supply is less, and what happens to the price? Price definitely increase. So that is what is happening, unethical practice, thereby increasing the price of the essential goods and, you know, just generating lots of profit. But at what cost? Again, using unethical practices at the cost of the customer's money. Next is media biasness. We are not new to media and biasness of media. Media, the person who tries to bribe, everybody tries to bribe this media, and media is getting bribed by everybody. Yes, you pay and you get to know, you get to see the best of your, you know, advertisement or promotional activities. Like for example, movies. I remember I saw one movie, I will not name the movie, but the first day, first show, the moment I saw the movie, I came out of the theater, there were these media people who were standing for taking the reviews. Okay, and based, you know, har baar ye hota hai, jab bhi naya movie aata hai to obviously thoda bahut reviews sabka dikhate hai. These people, because I didn't like the movie, so I didn't give such a good review. So they immediately cut short my review part. Why? Because they only wanted to show the positive. The people who are saying positive about the movie, they only wanted to showcase that. So by this we understand that how biased media is. They are not fair. They are not transparent. They just try to promote from you know, the person from where they are getting money. Next is different laws. It is somewhat similar like global norms. Different laws, there are different laws. Like for example, India mein marketing karne ke liye kuch alag laws hai, foreign mein marketing karne ke liye kuch alag laws hai. Not only that, even marketing differ from product to product. Like for example, you cannot directly market alcohol, tobacco or any such products. You cannot directly market the name of your competitor. You cannot show your the name of your competitor directly in any form of advertisement. So these are different laws. Now in other countries, again this is different. So people try to take the advantage of the difference in the law and they try to exploit that law. Next is dumping. Now what do you mean by dumping? Dumping is an activity where a home country company produce the product in large quantities, okay, and they sell it in the other country. They don't sell in their home country, or they sell in their home country but not at that level, but they actually keep the product for selling it in the other country at the low possible price. Even companies make losses for entering in the other country. Like for example, the best example of dumping is China. China kya karta hai? Apne products extra quantity mein banata hai aur India mein aake dump karta hai at the lowest possible price. Jo yahan ke manufacturer usko compete nahi kar sakte. So ultimately what happens? You have two similar products. One you get at 10 rupees, other you get at 5 rupees. Obviously you will opt for 5 rupees. Why? Because you are saving on the other 5 rupees. Same thing what China is doing with India right now. China just goes on dumping their product in India at the lowest possible price so that there is a complete elimination of competition. Once that competition is gone completely, these companies are going to shoot up the product price. Why? Because there is no competitor for them, thereby trying to create a monopoly situation. That is nothing but dumping. And the last is exploitation of labor. पहले भी था, आज भी है और पता नहीं और आगे कितने टाइम तक रहेगा. दैट लेबर्स आर गेटिंग एक्सप्लॉयटेड इन टर्म्स ऑफ नॉट गेटिंग प्रॉपर वेजेस, नो प्रॉपर वर्किंग कंडीशन, एक्सटेंडेड वर्किंग आवर्स. ओके, नाउ दीज ऑल हैव कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटेड टू वॉट, नथिंग बट एक्सप्लॉयटेशन ऑफ द लेबर. सो बेसिकली देर आर 10 पॉइंट्स वेन वी टॉक अबाउट इमर्जिंग एथिकल इश्यूज इन मार्केटिंग. अंडरस्टूड दिस मच? Okay, let's go to the next topic, that is importance of ethics. Now till now we have discussed that what are the problems, okay, now that ethical issues basically a marketing manager or a marketing field is encountering. Now we'll see why this ethics is so much important. Why people in today's time are focusing more on ethics, ethical company. What is all this ethics about? Now first thing is create image. The company who is ethical creates a goodwill in the market. Like for example, when we name Tata ke koi bhi company le lo, jab unka naam lete hai to automatic respect aa jati hai. Why? Because this company is known for their ethical values. So when a company is ethically correct or they follow ethics, not only the top management but at every level person is following ethics, then the company creates a goodwill. Like for example, अगर मेरे को कोई सैमसंग का रिव्यूज पूछेगा, आई विल गिव द वर्स्ट और द नेगेटिव रिव्यूज ऑफ सैमसंग. व्हाई? बिकॉज आई एम नॉट एट ऑल सेटिस्फाइड विद दैट प्रोडक्ट, विद दैट कंपनी. सो ऑब्वियसली एवरीबडी हैज देयर पर्सनल एक्सपीरियंसेस. माय एक्सपीरियंस विद सैमसंग वाज टू बैड. अभी उसके लिए मेरे दिमाग में उसकी इमेज कैसी हो गई? नेगेटिव, खराब हो गई. व्हाई? बिकॉज दैट सैमसंग इज नो मोर अ एथिकल कंपनी, आई विल से. And similarly, when I go out in the crowd and I tell it to more people, I actually found that many people support my views. Why? Because they are also not happy with Samsung. So when a company follows ethics, then obviously they will be able to create a good image in front of the customers. And it's a vice versa case as well. Second point, increase sales. Now when a company is ethically correct, okay, people blindly believe in that company. And ultimately they go and purchase a product, customer undoubtedly become a loyal customer for that company, and thereby company can increase their sales. Next, build relationship. There is a strong tie-up or a relationship between the company and the customer. The ethical company always believe in becoming a preferred customer loyal company. So when I want that customer should be loyal to my company, I need to follow ethics. Why? Because I cannot fool customer at all. Customer is much more aware of, you know, about the product, about the market, about the rules and regulation. So if I try to, as a company, if I try to fool the customer, I am losing the customer. So ultimately, I need to follow ethics for increasing my sale, and not only that, but to build a long-term relationship with the customers. Next is less government interference. If a company is ethical in the eyes of the government, even government will not put a strict control or keep observing the the company completely. They will have less interference in the companies. But if a company is unethical, even government is aware, yaar ye to kuch gadbad karne wali hai, aur ye company jaani hi uske liye jaati hai jo ye gadbad karne wali hai, to company uske government uske upar surveillance zyada rakhta hai. They keep an eye on these kind of companies. So when a company is ethical, they will find that government will not or will completely I'll not say completely they won't interfere, but yes, the involvement or the interference will come down drastically. Next, lowers marketing cost. Now, what is marketing for? Marketing is nothing but creating awareness, education about the product to the customers. Now, when a company is ethical, customer ultimately, you know, has a good image in the mind of their, in their mind for the product, for the company. So now company will not focus on going on marketing again and again, again and again of their products. Why? Because they know, even customer is aware that by ye company barabar hai, hum iske paas se hi product khareedenge. So ab customer mera loyal ho chuka hai, then why will I spend more on marketing? So that's how the company also lowers the cost of marketing. Next, facilitates brand extension. Brand extension is nothing but introducing new products in the same brand. Like for example, when we talk about let's talk about Nike, okay? When Nike was introduced, they were only into sportswear shoes. Slowly, steadily, when they you know, understood that customer has become loyal, customer happy with the products, they went on brand extension. Now they have a complete sportswear showroom. You will not find even a single product which is of sportswear and they don't have. They have from rackets to belts and, you know, swimming suits and jogging suits and every socks, everything. You name a sportswear and you will get it in the Nike showroom. So that is nothing but when my company is, you know, so famous, they have a goodwill in the market, then I can easily go for brand extension. Recommendation. What do you mean by recommendation? It is nothing but mouth-to-mouth publicity or done by the customer basically. Now, if I am satisfied with some product, I will recommend it to my family, my friends, my relative, my neighbors, my colleagues. I am going to definitely recommend them. Like for example, right now, what is happening with the movie Sultan? Many people are very happy with Sultan. So, kya kar rahe hain? Ek bar jaake dekh. Ghar pe mat dekh. Jaake theater mein dekh. So, what they are doing? They are trying to recommend us. Why? Because they are in a favorable, view. Whereas I have found the other way also. Yeah, don't spend money on Sultan. You just watch it at home. Even if you get for free, don't spend an hour watching that movie. I have got these kind of reviews as well. So it's a mixed review for me. Similarly, the customer who was satisfied will definitely recommend in the positive way, and the customer who are not satisfied will recommend but in a negative way. If you want to do it, you do it at your choice. This is what the statement ends with. Okay. And the last one, securing finance. Now, when a company is very much ethical or following all norms or moral values and everything, these companies get easy finances. How they get easy finances? Because they have a good name in front of shareholders, not only shareholders but bankers, creditors, everybody. And these people are ready to invest in such kind of companies who are actually following the ethical norms. So for a company to secure finances becomes very easy just by following ethics. So there are eight importance of ethics when it comes to marketing. Let's go further. Challenges before marketing manager in changing business environment. Now, we do agree that we are staying in an environment which is dynamic in nature. What do you mean by dynamic? Dynamic is ever changing. You just observe your behavior, you as a customer. Every day in, day out. Aaj agar koi mobile acha laga, immediately next second mein, next day mein, next hour mein koi aur mobile acha lagega. Aaj koi gaadi abhi achi lag gayi, jab buy karne jaoge tab tak tumhara mind change ho jayega. Nahi ye khareedni. So if customer not only customer but the entire environment is keeping on changing. People prior, down the line 10 years before, there was no concept of buying a CNG car or a LPG car. Now people are focusing more of CNG car. Why? Cost friendly. Okay, so basically the environment is going on changing. Now, in such a situation, it will be very difficult for a marketing manager to cope up these changes. So what basic challenges does a marketing manager face in today's time? Let us see that. First of all, global market. Yes, global market, again, as we covered over here, global market means what? Our economy has opened up to the for global presence. Now, when my economy has opened up, the taste, preferences, likes, dislike of each and every customer changes. Now, how the customers' likes and dislikes are influenced? They are influenced by the social values, by their family, by their peers, by their colleagues. Okay, not only that, their even choices are different because of money. The choices differ because of money, occupation, economic level of the individual. Okay, future plannings, everything, you know, a customer thinks from 360 degrees analysis. Okay, so it becomes very difficult for a marketing manager to actually analyze only customer. Now, in such a scenario, even my economic world is changing. My demographic world is changing. Again, political world is not stable. Legal world is changing. So it becomes very, very difficult for a marketing manager to cope up with the entire environmental factors. Not when it comes to not only home country, but even global countries. Second, compressed PLC. What do you mean by PLC? PLC is nothing but product life cycle. Now, as human being has 5 stages of life cycle, similarly product also have a stage. Now, if there the product is divided into 4 stages or 4 stages in life cycle. First is when it gets introduced in the market for the first time. Now, at this stage, if people are, there are few people who buy this product. Now, if they are satisfied, it goes further viral for other product, other people. So then if the product is positive or people are happy, the product attends the growth age, growth stage. Now, what do you mean by growth stage? Initially, jab product introduced hua tha, the 5 logo ne kharida. Now, there are 500 people who have purchased the product. So that is nothing but growing. Okay. Third stage comes the maturity. Now, once 500 people have purchased during growth, now 50,000 people have purchased. So that means it has attained maximum sales. Jitna sales ho sakta tha, wo ek maturity stage pe khatam ho gaya. So maturity is a stage where company generates maximum profits and maximum sales. And finally, decline. Why decline? Because people like change. Okay, people like to buy new product. And not only that, when you have attained maturity, obviously your competitors have followed you and they have introduced something good in the market. So now my existing product starts declining. A very classic example you can say is about any product you talk, but right now the example which I'll give is mobile phones. Okay, let's talk about Apple iPhone. Apple iPhone, when it is getting introduced in the market for the first time, it is priced very high, you know, like for example 50,000, 60,000. Now at that time it has only few buyers. Slowly, steadily, what happens? The awareness increases, people's, you know, people want increase, desire increase, and ultimately from 5 to 10 people, the 50 to 100 people goes and buys that product. So now that product is accepted and it starts growing. Further, once the growth has attained, company try to reduce the price of the product. Thereby, the product reaches the maturity stage where maximum number of people can buy the product. And finally, when the other competitors introduce their new products, these products, okay, unless and until it is a modified or some new innovation has been taken place, if I keep the product same, it definitely declines, it dies. Okay, now this is a basic product life cycle. Now, what is the problem because of this, what you can say, business environment? The product life cycle has really become shorter. Now, people want, now if you see, for example, her car company almost 2 mahine ke andar nayi nayi car nikalti hai, naye naye models nikalti hai. Bhale slight difference hoga, par naya model introduce karti hai. Kyun? Because it is public demand. Not only that, abhi ek Fiat ki car dekh lo, Ambassador. 50 साल से एक ही गाड़ी चली उनकी, 50 years no change in the model, Ambassador if you remember, yes, so तभी चल जाता था, अभी नहीं चल रहा है, people want change, people want new product, so that's why जो पहले 50 साल एक ही गाड़ी चली, आज उसकी life 2 महीना हो चुकी है, so that is the meaning of compressed PLC, now the life of the product has really become shorter, okay. Third is increasing customer awareness because of technological, what you can say, influence. People are, you know, open to the complete media world. Media hai, information, education hai. People have, you know, increased their education levels. Again, mouth-to-mouth publicity. Again, I'll say, more open towards internet facilities, okay, mobile internet. So what has happened because of all these online services or internet services, people have actually opened up to the complete knowledge world. So it is not easy to fool a customer in today's time. customer awareness. Customer, as I said, customer is very well aware what are the brands that are available, what is the price that is available in the market, or what are the laws to protect himself. So he has become much more aware than a person who is working in the organization. So that is also a challenging task for a marketing manager. He cannot fool the customer easily. He cannot sell just any product to the customer. Okay. Next, technological boom. Just now I said, a very good example is mobile phone. Because of mobile phone, there are 9 different companies who have suffered. Now, which are that 9 companies? First of all, landline company, MTNL. Second is camera making company. Third is watch making company. Fifth is alarm making company. Sixth is notepad making company. Seventh is diaries, calendars. Okay, the calendar is the 7th one. Then what else? Music systems. Yes, music system. It has replaced your music system. And the last is the memory, because it again stores all the data that you want. Computer, it has actually replaced your computers. So what has happened? There is a technological boom. Every time the standard of mobile phone is increasing. Thereby other companies are suffering. And these technological boom has given what? An awareness to the customer, choice to the customer, whether what kind of product they want and at what price they want. Again, that becomes a very much challenging task for the marketing manager, because he cannot stop technological boom. What he can do is he can just upgrade his own products, or he can just spend more on R&D, innovation, and get a new product in the market in order to survive. And last is emergence of social media. Yes, social media is nothing but social networking sites. Now people are very much scared. Even these marketing managers are scared about these social media. Why? If there is a fraud which is done by any company to a customer, customer immediately post it on the company's website, or they put it on the social networking site like Facebook, Twitter and all, because of which negative publicity of the company and the products takes place at a huge level. So in order to protect from that scenario also, it is a very much challenging task for a marketing manager to survive and to come up with new ideas in order to get more customers or attract customers, or not attract, at least then retaining the existing customer. It becomes very difficult for a marketing manager. Yes, so understood all these points. By this, our first unit is complete. Now we'll further go to second unit. Before going to second unit, kindly take down the points.